Hi there, I'm Chris Devine, and this is Six String World. And this is my mid-90s Fender Made in Japan 50's reissue. I've been told this isn't the actual name for this particular model. If you do happen to know the technical name for this particular Fender Strat, please leave it in the comments section below. I'd love to know. Regardless, this is a Made in Japan Fender. It has a three-piece alder body, a maple neck, and all the specs after that are no longer in the proper Fender realm. I purchased this guitar in 1997 for the princely sum of $325. It had a few scratches and a few dings here and there. The scratches buffed out, but the dings added to the patina. It's had a bunch of different pickups in it over the years, and at one point it had a Seymour Duncan JB Jr. in the bridge, and I used this guitar as a backup for my PRS for a very long period of time, and it served me very well. One night in 2015, I was playing it, I was really enjoying it, but I started making note of a lot of the things I would like to change on it. And why I'd like to change those aspects. Unfortunately, at this time, I was really on a budget. So I allocated $25 a paycheck, which is $12.50 per week to fund the upgrades and mods that I wanted to do. The time it took me to save up the money gave me time to research and look at all of the options. Eventually, I did an article on this whole process for Performer Magazine, and I have a link for that article in the description below. I won't walk you through all of the steps of its evolution, but I will go through the specs as it sits now. I have Clusson vintage-style locking tuners. I have a man-made USA bridge. The pickups are by Seymour Duncan. And they're all stacked and hum canceling. In the neck, I have a vintage hot stack. In the middle is a classic stack. And the bridge is a custom. The pickguard is by Warmoth also. And if you haven't noticed, it's backwards. It actually has a reversed angle on there, kind of like you'd find on a Jimi Hendrix style guitar. Electronics wise, I did new pots and a new super switch. With the usual Strat type setup, except I have a tone knob for the bridge pickup, and in the middle position, it engages the neck and the bridge pickup together. Yes, I don't get the option to use the middle pickup on its own, but I've only ever used that position once in the studio. So what did all these changes yield? Well, first of all, I've always loved the PRS tremolo, and the man-made USA version is perfect for vintage style Strats. And that and the locking tuners really give excellent tuning stability and easy string changes. The silky smooth tremolo, it's excellent. The sustain is wonderful and it's very, very comfortable. Pickup wise, the hum is a lot lower. I do plan on shielding the cavity with copper tape at some point in the future. So getting those single coils without a lot of noise is really nice, and I would love to even further that experiment. The reverse bridge pickup does take a bit of high end off the B and the E strings. The mids are a little throatier, and the low end is a bit tighter. The good thing about that is if I get bored with this sound, I have a Strat pickguard that has it with the normal pickup configuration, and swapping it out isn't a big deal. The controls make sense. Master volume, the tone knob from the front covers the neck and the middle. The bottom one obviously covering the bridge. It's kind of an Eric Johnson mod. Eric Johnson has his tone knob wired to the bridge pickup. And there are times rolling a bit of that high end off of a bridge pickup thicken things up a bit. Now, it's not a mod that's going to make you sound like Eric Johnson, but it does open up some more tonal options. And it's kind of nice to be able to have that option, especially on the bridge pickup. Now, having the ability to use the neck and bridge pickup together is kind of telly-ish. But as these are hum canceling and I have separate tone controls, it's a bit less polish. I did a gig with my cover band with this guitar at one point, and I set my amp up for a semi-gritty tone, and I used the volume knob and the pickup selector to control the tones for the gig. It was really nice and a very refreshing approach and quite natural feeling overall to have all the tonal changes come through my hands, my picking, and on the guitar itself, not from pedals or presets or channel switching. If you total up the cost of the parts and the labor, these mods outweigh what I paid for this instrument. But the value is far better overall. First of all, I love this neck. It's a V-shaped profile, and it's kind of similar to some of the earlier Eric Clapton Strat necks, and it feels great with these vintage frets. All these changes made it do everything I wanted, and it makes me want to play it more. I thought of buying a Strat that was closer to these specs, but I would still be changing a whole bunch of stuff anyways, so it made better sense to start off with a guitar I was familiar with and knowing what the changes would bring to the table. I could have gone for one of those totally custom instruments from somebody like Soar or Anderson, LSL, or any of those amazing small craft type builders, but the prices on those are a bit steep. And remember, I was on a budget of $12.50 a week. And this whole process of mods and saving up the money for it took a couple of years to get through. Overall, it's a lot more giggable. As I said, I could easily do a gig with just this guitar with my cover band, no problem. And this has ended up on some recordings for my original band with this as well. And along the way, I did learn a lot about doing mods and what's worth doing and what's worth not pursuing as well. So that's my Strat. How about you folks? Do you have a Strat or another guitar that you've modified? Did you go down that rabbit hole that I did with very extensive changes? If so, leave a comment in the space below. If you like this channel, hit subscribe and the bell icon will let you know when I put up a new video. And if you like this video, give it the thumbs up button. And if you want to share it, there's a button for that as well. And that's fantastic. Thanks for watching and I'll see you soon. Take care.